Hi there guys, lovely to be with you all again today. It's Tuesday the 3rd of April. I was checking my suntan last night in the mirror and look at it today. Got my big Christmas cardigan out and on again because of the snowy weather. Oh, this Scottish weather is just amazing, but what can you do? You just have to get on with it. Well, I hope you stay warm today, and I hope you can still get a bite. Some of you are at Easter school. I hope it went really well, and others are working, and some of you are at home with the kids, and some of you are struggling with your health and that, and I just want to tell you that we're thinking of all of you today, and we're praying that God will really bless you. Just keep your wee emails coming. We're praying for those people that you've told us about. We're praying for you. Lovely to meet a lot of you over these last few days, giving out the Easter gifts, and it's been good to be able to do that and just share the love with our lovely wee local community. So God bless you all. Thanks for your wee emails, messages of support, messages of love. Thanks for saying good things about the videos and that you're enjoying them, and thanks for all your wee compliments. Keep them coming as well. It's lovely to have your love, and it's lovely to love you too. We're a wee verse in Psalm 90 verse 12 today, and it's a searching wee verse. It's a wee verse that makes you think, where he says in the Psalm, teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Sunday was April Fool's Day, and I was speaking to the young folks in our church Bible class on Sunday afternoon, and I was speaking on the topic of the fool. And of course, twice over in the Psalms, it says, the fool has said in his heart, there's no God. And the Bible proves to us, you know, that everything about God is just so clearly seen in the things that he's made, and that people are without excuse. But that people willingly turn away from God because they don't want to do what's right. They want to live their own lives their way. And they make a choice just to say there's no God, when really deep down in their heart and conscience, they know that God is real. But people make the choice. Don't make that choice. Don't be a fool. Be wise today and turn to God, to the God who made you, to the God who loves you, to the God who wants you with him in the place called heaven forever and ever. Why turn your back on him? Why go to hell when he loves you and he has got heaven waiting for you? So the Bible says, teach us to number our days. Don't know if you've ever thought about it. If you're 14 years old, you've lived over 5,000 days. If you're 30, just under 11,000 days. If you're 70, if you live, and I hope you do, till you're 70, you will have lived 25,500 days. You say, wow, that's a lot. But you know, when you get to 70, and I hope that you do, you'll have felt that it's flown by just like that. 25,000 days just flies by. And you know, the Bible says that we're not going to be here forever, and that we should number our days. That means we should really think about it. You've heard the wee term, the brevity of life. It just means life is short. And so it is. Even the longest life, even if you live to be 100, and maybe some of you will, it's still very, very short. And eternity, you see, is very, very long. In fact, eternity will never end. We're in time for a little while, and then we go out into God's great, big, vast, infinite eternity. The last letter of time is the letter E. The first letter of eternity is the letter E. And time will end, but eternity will never end. And the question is, where will you spend eternity? Where will you spend eternity? There's only two places, either heaven with Jesus or hell without him. And there's no annihilation. No one is going to cease to exist. Yes, we're all going to die, but the spirit and the soul live on. The spirit and the soul live the lifetime of God, which is forever and ever. And so your body will die, but your spirit and your soul, the part that's really you, my mum used to say, I used to ask her, what's my soul? She used to say, the part that's really you, the part that's really you, lives forever and ever. And as I say, either in heaven or in hell forever. So what will you do with Jesus? That's the big question. We're coming up to Good Friday, when everybody's going to be thinking about the death of Jesus, the awful suffering and torture and pain that he went through, the death that he died, the cruelest death that you could imagine. Jesus died out of love for you so that he could save you, so that he could bring you to heaven, so that he could keep you out of hell, so that he could forgive your sins, so that he could be your friend and your God, so that he could take you through life, no matter how many days it might be. Jesus wants to spend the days with you. And I'm happy to be able to say that these last 40 years, and all those thousands of days, I've spent them with Jesus. I've started them with him. I've ended them with him. That doesn't mean I've thought about him, every one of them. I'm sure he's crossed my mind at least once in them all. But you know what I'm saying, you know, I still get it wrong. I still mess up. But I've lived most of my days for Jesus. And I've lived them well with his help. But what about you today? What about you? Have you spent one day for Jesus out of all those thousands that he's given you? You know, one day we have to give account. One day we're going to stand before him. One day we're going to meet him. And he's going to say, what did you do with all those thousands of days that I gave you? And maybe your head is going to hang with shame, because you'll have to admit, Lord, I just wasted them. Lord, I just lived selfishly. Lord, I didn't even think about you. Lord, I didn't receive you as my Savior. I didn't make you my God. I didn't worship you. I didn't share you in my community, in my family, in my church. I just went my own selfish way. And sadly, he'll have to turn you away from heaven's gates. Say, depart from me. And how sad it is, but that's the reality, guys. You know, not everyone's getting into heaven. Only those who have trusted in Jesus and have proved it by going out and living life for him. As I say it publicly, you need to confess Jesus publicly. You need to let your friends know that you're a Christian. You need to take the stick in the classroom, in the college, in the university, in the hospital ward, in the office, in your family, in your street. You have to take the stick, because you're standing up publicly for Jesus. And Jesus says, you know, if you don't confess me before men, I'm not going to confess you before my Father in heaven. And so it takes courage, but he'll be with you. He'll help you. That's not to say that you go around Bible bashing everyone and putting people off, of course not. But with care and with love and with an interest in the people and with giving to them and loving them and being genuine with them, they will see Jesus in you, and some of them will respond and take him too. But hey guys, what's it going to be? Number your days, guys. Who knows? Maybe someone watching the video today, maybe this is your last day on earth. Tomorrow you'll be in eternity. And what's it going to be? With Jesus or without him? Hey guys, we might have one day. I don't know. It might be my last day, and I want to plead with you as if it were my last day, and it might well be, come to Jesus. He's your only hope, and Jesus will save you, and Jesus will bless you, and Jesus will be with you, and Jesus will take you through. All your problems won't disappear, oh no, but you'll have a friend to help you. He'll be with you 24/7. And Jesus has said, I'll never leave you and I'll never forsake you. Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. I want you to be wise, not a fool. Don't just turn away. Don't act foolishly now. You've heard what I said. You know I'm saying what I'm saying is true. So be wise today. Let wisdom into your heart. Let Jesus into your heart. And become a new person, a Christian, a man, a woman of God, today, and live for Jesus. Whether it's a few days, 100 days, 1,000 days, or many more thousands, but let them count for him, and you won't regret it. Trixie and I love you all very, very much. God bless you, and see you tomorrow, if God allows it. Bye for now.